Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Lin Yan. I have prepared several slides today discussing about Tesla Model Y heat pump system. This is a Tesla patent published last year. This patent shows the thermal management system of a pure battery electric vehicle which involves with a heat pump system, and it also discusses Octovalve. I will show you more in the following slides. Here is a diagram from the patent. It shows a thermal management system which includes a heat pump system, a battery system, and a drivetrain coolant loop and control electronics. You can find all the components within the heat pump system, like the compressor, cabin condenser, cabin evaporator. The battery system coolant loop and the drivetrain coolant loop are in contact with the heat pump system by circulating coolant flows. The control electronics control different settings of the components, such as the operation of compressor, coolant pumps, octovalve, and compressor outlet three-way valve. Here is a recent photo of the octovalve taken by auto teardown expert Sandy Murrow. It is an octopus with a snowflake on its head. And this is a schematic of the octovalve from the patent. As you can see, there are four different coolant loops involved within the octovalve: the radiator coolant loop, the chiller coolant loop, the battery coolant loop, and the drivetrain coolant loop. By changing the mode of the octovalve, the four loops can form two different coolant loops, like the upper left graph, or they can be all connected in series, like the upper right graph. For the two graphs below, the difference is the radiator. By changing the radiator valve, the radiator can either be used or bypassed. I will use these drawings to represent different modes of the octovalve in the following schematics: 01, 02, 03, and 04. Now, with all this information, it is just a matter of time, effort to link all the components together and solve this big puzzle. Elon Musk has mentioned the octovalve in a previous Twitter while responding to a Tesla community member who inquired if the Model Y had a solution that is better than the supermodel. Musk confirmed in his Twitter and noted that octovalve is pretty special. Okay, this is a key slide of this presentation, the potential schematics of the thermal management system of the Tesla Model Y. The red lines represent refrigerant flow, while the blue lines represent coolant flows. I will first show you some pictures of the components from Tesla Model Y and then explain how the system works. Thanks to Sandy Murrow teardown videos, here is a picture under the hood of Tesla Model Y. This is a compressor, this is a liquid cooled condenser, and this is a chiller. Here is a picture from Sandy Murrow teardown video as well. It shows the HVAC case, which involves filter, cabin evaporator, and cabin condenser. Starting from this slide, I will show you several modes of this complex thermal management system. The slide is when the refrigerant system is off and the octovalve is at 01 state. The refrigerant system off, which means the compressor is off, and these lines are dashed lines, which means there is no refrigerant flow. And the radiator is in connection with the drivetrain, and the battery is in connection with the chiller, which is inactive. So the coolant will take the heat from drivetrain and circulate to the radiator, where it can be cooled by the incoming ambient air. The fan will be on. And for the battery coolant loop, coolant will be recirculated through the battery to minimize temperature spread within the battery. This is another mode when the refrigerant system is off and the octovalve is at 02 state. The radiator is used to cool the battery and the drivetrain. This slide shows the air conditioning mode of the thermal management system. The refrigerant is compressed by the compressor, then it goes to the liquid cooled condenser to be cooled by the coolant. Then it goes either or both EXV to get expanded. When refrigerant gets expanded, it becomes very cold. Then it goes to the chiller and or cabin evaporator to cool the battery and or the cabin. Then they merge together and then go to the reservoir and then go to the compressor to be compressed again. Note, the 12-volt heater is used to add heat needed for the cabin if needed. This slide is when the refrigerant system is at AC mode and the Octovalve is at O1 mode. This mode enables cabin cooling by the cabin evaporator, and the chiller is connected with the battery to cool the battery. The radiator is used to cool the drivetrain unit. This slide is when the Octovalve is changed to O2 position, O2 mode. The chiller is used to cool the battery and the drivetrain, and the radiator is bypassed by controlling the radiator valve. Okay, this slide shows the heat pump mode of the refrigerant system. The refrigerant is compressed by the compressor, then it goes to the cabin condenser to heat the cabin. This is controlled by the three-way valve after the compressor. Then the refrigerant goes to the EXV to get expanded, then go to the chiller to obtain heat from the free low-grade heat sources by coolant. Then the refrigerant goes to the reservoir, then go to the compressor to be compressed again. Note that the orange dashed line is optional for cabin dehumidification, and the 12-volt heater is optional too. This slide shows the mode when the refrigerant system is at heat pump mode and the Octovalve is at O1 state. The cabin is heated by the cabin condenser and the chiller is connected with the battery to utilize the heat from the battery. The radiator is bypassed by controlling the radiator valve. The liquid cooled condenser is inactive in this case. This slide shows the mode when the refrigerant system is at heat pump mode and the Octovalve is at O2 position. The cabin is heated by the cabin condenser, and the chiller is connected with the battery, the drivetrain unit, and the radiator to utilize the heat from the battery, drivetrain unit, and the ambient. The liquid cooled condenser is inactive too. This slide shows the mode when the refrigerant system is at heat pump mode and the Octovalve is at O4 position. The cabin is heated by the cabin condenser. The chiller is connected with the radiator to utilize the heat from the ambient. The liquid cooled condenser is inactive too. In this slide, it lists all the modes. There are 12 heating modes and three cooling modes listed from this patent. So I haven't draw all the schematics of all the modes, but you can see using this schematic, the thermal management system can enable a lot of different modes, which can be operated under different conditions to maximize its efficiency and comfort. To summarize, by using this particular heat pump, it can save a high voltage heater. Instead, this heat pump system uses a low voltage heater. For prior Tesla, like the Model S, Model 3, and Model X, they use a high voltage PTC heater, which are quick but less efficient than heat pumps. Using heat pump techniques, the efficiency for heating can be as high as 300 to 500%, which can increase the range of vehicle under cold ambience. This will greatly reduce the range anxiety of many customers who live in cold regions. Also, by adopting Octovalve, Tesla saves on space, assembly costs, and the final assembly time. Thank you for watching. If you feel you learned something from this presentation, please don't forget to give me a thumb up and subscribe. Thank you.